Hi, this is Amy, and today I want to talk to you guys who are administrators about using short URLs. So this might seem like, why do I need to know that? You know, how is that ever going to impact me? And I want to try to convince you that this could be a really big deal for you to use as well as for you to model for teachers. So the idea is, let's say you're having a faculty meeting or something like that, and you've created a document like this one and you want people to comment on it or collaborate on it. Well, if you have a group of people who you don't already have in a mailing list, then it can be, you know, it can be difficult to get them all to this web address that's up here in the top in my Omnibox because it's too long for anyone to type in. So what you want to be able to do is you want to be able to shorten that address down so that people can actually get to this web address because nobody can type that in. This is obviously really valuable for teachers in a classroom when you want students to be able to work on a document together, to collaborate, or, you know, just to get to the same web page even. All right, so that's the purpose of the tool, and now I want to show you how you can use it. So the first thing you want to do is you want to install the Chrome extension. So I've just toggled over to an account that doesn't already have that extension installed so that I can show you how it looks. So when you want to install a new extension in Chrome and you're using a regular computer, then you open up a new tab. So you can always click that little tab on the end and that will give you a new tab. And when you click that, you're going to see an opportunity to get to the Chrome Web Store, which is right here. If you're using a Chromebook, then you'll look down in the bottom right-hand corner right down here, and you'll see a series of little squares inside a square, and that's where you click to get to the Chrome Web Store. So let's go into the store, and then let's look for the extension that we're going to use today, which is called bit.ly. So we're going to type in bit.ly, and it is an extension, not an app. So we want to make sure that we're looking for the correct thing. See how at the top we've got apps listed and down here we've got extensions listed. So we want to find the correct one, and this is it right here, bit.ly. So this is a really awesome, it's my new favorite thing I found. So it's got a little blowfish there. See, I thought it was a bird at first because it looks kind of like a bird, but apparently it's not. It's a blowfish. So we're going to click on where it says plus free and we're going to choose add to add it to our browser. And once we see it pop up, I'm going to take mine and move it over here so you can really see it. And now once we've added it, we're going to authorize the extension. So sometimes when you first get an extension, you're going to need to sign into it. So I'm going to authorize it for use with Chrome. I just clicked on it. This page appeared and I'm going to choose sign in with your email address. So let me try my email address. So if you don't already have an account, it's not going to let you just type in your email address and your password. You're going to actually have to sign up for an account. And I'll show you in just a second how to get to that place to do that. So I'm going to leave the settings as they are, default, and now I can just start using bit.ly. But let's pretend that you don't already have an account and you want to set one up with your email address. You don't use Facebook or Twitter, or you don't want to use that account. So let's go ahead and look at how to get to that page. So if you don't have an account already, you don't want to use Facebook or Twitter, then you can just go to bit.ly.com and you can click on Join Now, and you can actually create an account right here with your email address. But I've already got an account, so I'm just going to sign back in again, and then we'll look at how to use the extension. All right, so here we are, and I'm logged in to bit.ly.com now, and I'm also authorized this extension. So let's pretend a scenario. Let's pretend that we're in a class, and we've all navigated to this awesome web page. So let me pull up an awesome web page so we can pretend. So here's an awesome web page, and let's pretend that we want everybody to get to this page. So I'm going to click my little bit.ly fish over here. Since I know it's a fish now, I almost said bird again, but it's a fish. And I'm going to allow my extension. If you haven't done that already, it will make you log in. And let's try that again, because you really shouldn't have that many steps. I just got that because I signed out just now. So let me try it again. I'm going to shorten my URL by clicking my blowfish up here. All right, so we click the fish. There we are. We're going to click Save Bitmark. I don't want to type a note on that one. And now we have a couple of options. We can, if we want, just use this URL that's right here, and this can be our short URL. So I'm going to hit Command C on that, and I'm going to paste it into our document over here so you can see what that looks like. So this is an unedited short URL, and this will work. And we can be, wrong URL. Let me copy that. So I'm going to go back over to our page, hit the copy button, and then I'm going to paste it in this document so you can see what it looks like. So there it is, and this short URL will work, and we can use that. People can type that in. But it's kind of long, and it's not as easy to type in as maybe a real word would be. So let's go back over to our page, and let's actually edit that bitmark. So let's make this. My district is HISD Huntsville ISD, so we'll do HISD Design. And now I'll hit enter on my keyboard, and now the URL, since no one else had chosen that already, now the URL is HISD-Design. So now let me copy that, and I'm going to go back over to my document, and I can paste this in, and I can put it up on the big screen so everybody can see it, and they'll be able to all get to this web page. So let me get a couple of people to click this so that we can look at the stats on it. So here's another example of how we can use this. So I'm going to ask people on Twitter to click this URL so that I can build some stats on it to show you for our video. But what that lets me do is, let's say I'm working on, you know, a weekly newsletter or something like that, and I want to see how many people actually click the links that I put in this newsletter. Well, if I use Bitly to build those short URLs, I'm going to be able to see statistics. So now when I go back to Bitly and I look at the life of this link so far, I can see that as of when I clicked that button, two people had clicked this. Let's go back and see how to get to our whole list of URLs so we can see what's happened to them. All right, so here we are, and I just went to bit.ly.com, and since I'm logged in, it shows me it's your stuff up here at the top, and here are my bitmarks, and I can see that as of a couple of minutes ago, three people have clicked my link, and now I can go into view stats, and I can see more information. So here we are, and I've had three clicks at 156, another click at 157, and let's see. Three of those came from Twitter, and I probably clicked it once from my machine. Everybody is in the United States, and these are the other people who have also shared that link to that exact same page, so that's kind of interesting too. I can also get some more information about this. I can get a QR code. If I download this QR code, if you scanned this right now, it would actually make it so you go to that same web page. So if you have mobile users in your audience, you'll have a QR code that you can use to also get them there. I can email it to someone, and then I can also post it on Facebook or Twitter. So let's see if we got any more clicks on it since we were working on this tutorial. And we did. You can see we got a couple more clicks here. So that will keep growing as people keep clicking that link. So if you're watching from Twitter and wanted this tutorial and that's why you clicked the link, thanks for doing that. All right, so let's just recap. We want to get the Bitly extension in Chrome. It really has the most access of any URL shortener. I really used to be in love with goo.gl, and it's still my friend, but I have to move it over one because Bitly has the added ability to let me customize those bookmarks, and that's super valuable. I didn't show you how to do it today, but also you can make packs of links so that there's more than one link all packaged in there together. People can get to all of them. Super, super valuable for the classroom. So that's how you do it. Hopefully that helps. You don't have to customize. You can use what it gives you automatically. And don't forget to go back and look at your stats, especially if you use Twitter, Facebook, some kind of social network, Google+. It's really interesting to see what happens to those links. Could be really great for your students. You know, they don't provide any identifying information, but they want to get some views on their work that they've published online. That could be a neat way for them to look and see how people from all over the world can really see their work. So I hope that that helps and you learned something new. If you like this tutorial, please follow my blog. It's friedtechnology.com. There it is right there. And also, I'd love it if you subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/friedtechnologyamy. And you can hit subscribe there if you want more videos like this. Thanks. I hope you learned something new. Leave me some comments and have a great day. Bye-bye.